And now, live in the Madhouse studio, the two guys that have brought Madhouse TV to the nation, Tom Mealy and Tommy Marr.
Well, here we are. It's Wednesday night, and he already fell off the stool. Usually the wagon, but tonight it's the stool. Now you're going to drop the coffee and everything. Oh, my God.
Drop it. I just had a friggin' pretzel because I had... And now I was stuck in my tooth. Hey, listen, thanks for watching last week. Hey, today is no joke. Today is 9/11.
That's, yeah. We would, everyone here in Madhouse sends out all our prayers and blessings to all the victims of 9/11 and their families and anyone that has been touched by their lives. We, you know, our deepest sympathy to all.
Yeah, we want to give a special hello to the Hard Hat Heroes, who actually, I wish I could have went with you guys. They are down in Washington, D.C. right now, trying to keep them Muslims backed up a little bit. They're pushing them back across the line where they belong. I shouldn't have said that, should I?
I just saw a picture.
Should I have said that?
You already did.
Who's going to care, right?
You already did. It's been done.
Did they do it?
Well, I saw a picture. I think Vicky actually put up a picture. It was massive.
How many bikes?
As far as you could see in the picture.
Really?
As far as you could see.
No, I heard the governor of Virginia actually shut down parts of the highway to allow for these bikes. There's like millions. They were coming from all over the place. I mean, do you think, I hate to say, do you think that towel unwrapped? But I mean, I don't know. What do you think was going through their heads when they saw all these bikes coming in? I mean, that was a pretty fucked
probably
up thing.
Probably the same
really
thing as the, like the mayor of Iwo Jima.
The what?
The mayor of Iwo Jima.
The mayor of, I don't think he was.
Have you never heard that joke?
No.
What the F was that?
I still don't
the nuclear
get it.
Bomb went off in Hiroshima.
I don't get it. Anyway, listen, guys, good job down there. TJ, I wish I could be with you. I wish I could have gone down there. I tried everything under my power to get you a bike. I understand you drove down there in a Mercedes. Hey, listen, you know what? You take the good with the bad. I guess if you're going to go down in a car, what better car to go down to is a nice 500 SL convertible, right? What do you think? You used to have one of those, didn't you?
Yeah, I did have
Why'd
one of those.
Why'd you trade it for this thing? You want to go down that story?
I don't want to go there.
Why?
I mean, I don't want my blood pressure going up.
It's a pretty car you got.
I don't want. Let's move on to bigger and better
things.
Okay,
you got scratches on the side, too.
I know. It's from my grandson's taking out the garbage, actually.
Anyway, TJ, he's having a great time down there, and we wish you guys a safe trip back here to New York. And again, 9/11, you know, it comes around once a year, but we really need to stop and reflect that day changed so many people's lives here. Just under 3,000 people at the center. But you know, one thing that really bothers me about this whole thing, I was listening to it this morning. They start talking about the first responders, and everything is the first responders, right? Tell me what happened. Where's all the guys that went in there and dug all that shit out of there?
Well,
why don't they mention
I know
those
guys.
I know you do. But why don't they mention them? That's my problem.
Well, you know me, and you know that's been an issue with me for a long time. And believe me, not taking away anything from anybody,
no,
police, firemen, but I got to tell you, the guys that were in there digging in that hole for a long, many weeks, and putting their lives on the line, were construction
workers.
Yeah,
workers. And where
and
were these
were,
people?
And
where
not
were
only,
the ones that died from that, from all the poisons?
And yet to die from it. And not only that, they gave up their salaries for months.
That's right.
Weeks and months for their own families.
Yeah.
And, you know, like I said, not taking away from anybody else, but boy, I think these guys should be put on a pedestal. I know them. I personally sent a lot of them down there. Believe me, you never hear about them. And that's one thing that should definitely change.
I mean, these guys,
but you're
going to
hear about
the
dogs.
What about the dogs and all those dogs? You saw them with those things on their feet,
digging
through that rubble. They were all full of blood. I mean, all of these animals that helped in pulling these, you know, whatever survivors they found out of that thing. You know, it just bothers me because, you know, volunteer, you never hear of that. Everything is the first responders. And again, we're not taking away from the responders. Yeah, you know, the towers get hit. These guys race in there. They run into danger. But at the same time, you guys were down there in the trenches. You tell me a pipe can't fall on your head?
It's a
beam fall on your head?
I mean, look, we had T.J. Gilmartin in here last week. How many people did he personally know that's passed away? And he's got you know, he's got issues.
It just bothers me a little bit. But anyway, you know what? Our prayers are out to all the families out there. I mean, I know some personally that their children were in the tower at the time it was hit. I can only imagine what they're going through every year for the rest of their lives. But let's get past that. We have, before we bring our guest on, I know we're going to go to commercial and everything, but tell me a little about this guy. Who are we bringing on tonight?
He's the man.
How do you know that?
I know.
What does he do?
He builds guitars that no one else in this world builds.
You sure about that?
I'm positive.
And you've seen these things?
There's actually one in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame.
Really?
Yes, there is. And he's the only non-artist in the world to have a guitar in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame.
You think he'll donate one to Madhouse?
No.
Why?
Because they're too expensive.
But wait a minute. Hold on a second. Let's just back up a little second here. All right? We're seen literally around the world, all right? Realistically, how many people walk through the door of the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame to look at the guitars? I mean, it's an honor to be in there.
Well,
but I would think that if this fellow, what's his name?
His name is Mr. George Fedden.
Okay. I think that Mr. George Fedden should seriously consider building Madhouse TV a guitar.
Well, I say this. We've had how many shows in this place?
I don't know. Thousands.
The only thing I ever got was some wacky chiropractor that tried to crack my back on the couch. So I'm not asking him for a $6,000 guitar.
Is that how much they are? $6,000?
Hey, you know what? There was one on eBay for $50,000.
And what makes these
guitars?
I guess we'll find out sooner or later what makes these guitars so incredible. I did really have an opportunity to look at them.
And you've heard them, too.
And being a guitar connoisseur like I am,
Yes, go ahead.
I'm trying to tell him.
I know, right? Go ahead.
Understand something. We had to plug it in because the pickups were not exactly in sync with one another.
Because they're so high tech.
That's right. So we had to do something.
You
got to
understand,
different.
These things are built. They're not just, you know, they're not in a factory line that comes out. I mean, there's only six of them in the world.
Six?
Yeah.
Does one have Madhouse's name on it? I don't see it.
Absolutely not.
I don't think so.
Neither Sharpie.
Anyway, all right.
George just said he needs a Sharpie.
No, we're really happy to have George here. He builds these incredible. Wait till you see them. And then he also brought, what's his friend's name? The guy with the funny hat?
Lenny.
Lenny. He brought this guy, Lenny, in that's going to actually play the guitar. And I heard him practice. He's phenomenal. And I got to tell you, he really puts this guitar to the test.
Well, I'll tell you. I mean, I know for the people who have watched the shows, I mean, and you were here that night,
yeah,
too, with Andre LaSalle when
right.
he played it.
Right. Oh, yes,
it
yes.
It was amazing.
That was right. Yeah.
Amazing when he played.
I guess, you know, all joking aside, there's got to be a lot that goes into building a guitar. I mean, you know, I walk into a place like Sam Ash and I see these guitars hanging on the wall and they're $100, $200. And realistically, they don't even compare to what the sound of these
$200
machines.
You might as well take a broomstick and put some rubber bands on it. I mean, there's nothing.
You know, I did see that one time. There was a Chinese guy. I forget. Vicky and I were up in Canada, and there was this Chinese guy on the thing. He had a stick and he had a bunch of rubber bands on. He was plucking it, but he nice music.
Yeah. Well, they have the cigar box guitars and.
Anyway, be it as it may, we're going to cut to a quick commercial right here. When we come back, we're going to introduce Mr. George. And anything else you want to say?
I want to say, all you guitar players or anyone that collects guitars or any people that sell guitars, get settled, tune in, get your pens ready, because when you see these bad boys, you're all going to want one.
Hey, listen, before we go off, I don't know if our engineer can get our telephone number up on the bottom of the screen right now. If we can get up there, right over here on the bottom of the screen, right here, right in here. That's where it's sitting, right here.
Yeah,
that's it, right there.
Feel free
give
to call.
Call. Talk to George personally. You have any questions regarding these guitars, give us a call. Where phone lines are open right now. Ask him any questions you want to ask him about these guitars, and we'll go from there. We'll be right back, right?
Yes, sir.
See you later. Right back. Don't go anywhere.
Are
Are you planning an event and want to include entertainment, but you're not sure where to turn?
Act1Entertainment.net has provided over 1,500 events with quality, affordable live entertainment at private parties, corporate affairs, festivals, bike rallies, and more. Act One will fit into your budget. They're friendly, reliable, and do all the legwork for you. They take all major credit cards. Log on to Act1Entertainment.net for a free, no-obligation price quote or call 631-758-3505 for a brochure.
You'll be happy you did.
For professional motorcycle transport and towing, think Kickstart Fabrications Motorcycle Towing. Proudly serving all of Long Island, we feature expert handling and 24/7 service. So send a limo for your toy with Kickstart Fabrications Motorcycle Towing.
This is Beth.
Hi.
Oh, congratulations. When are you due?
I'm not pregnant.
Oh, look at that. Excuse me.
You're totally thin.
You look very sexy.
For life's bleachable moments, all it takes is 3/4 cup.
When your cable's on the fritz, you get frustrated. When you get frustrated, your daughter imitates. When your daughter imitates, she gets thrown out of school. When she gets thrown out of school, she meets undesirables. When she meets undesirables, she ties the knot with undesirables. And when she ties the knot with undesirables, you get a grandson with a dog collar. Don't have a grandson with a dog collar. Get rid of cable and upgrade to DirecTV. Call 1-800-DIRECTV. When your cable company keeps you on hold, you get angry. When you get angry, you go blow off steam. When you go blow off steam, accidents happen. When accidents happen, you get an eye patch. When you get an eye patch, people think you're tough. When people think you're tough, people want to see how tough. And when people want to see how tough, you wake up in a roadside ditch. Don't wake up in a roadside ditch. Get rid of cable and upgrade to DirecTV. Call 1-800-DIRECTV. When you pay too much for cable, you throw things. When you throw things, people think you have anger issues. When people think you have anger issues, your schedule clears up. When your schedule clears up, you grow a scraggly beard. When you grow a scraggly beard, you start taking in stray animals. And when you start taking in stray animals, you can't stop taking in stray animals. Stop taking in stray animals. Get rid of cable and upgrade to DirecTV. Call 1-800-DIRECTV.
Ask you a question real quick before we bring George on. I got a guitar right here that I just want to ask you. I don't know if you can see it. What would you make of this masterpiece?
I think the fire thing is a good thought.
That's about it.
Light it on
fire. You know who this is from? This is from my buddy.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Who's your buddy?
My buddy.
Oh.
The Dean?
Brett Michaels.
Oh, hey. Hey.
Well, don't bring Brett Michaels up. Oh, excuse me.
Bring me back to the 60s.
Yeah, okay. All right. Anyway, it is with great pleasure.
Well, first of all, I want to say it is a great pleasure to have George here tonight. This is George Fedden, and he is a personal friend. He's a friend of Madhouse's. He's been here many, many times. We've done many shows at B.B. King's in New York
together. Chris Pants a lot.
We've done some festivals together. We've done a lot of things together. And he's also a great guy. But I also would love to extend our deepest, deepest sorrow on the loss of your son.
Right. And thank you. Appreciate it.
I mean,
Peter's here with us now.
Oh, without a doubt. Yeah. Without a doubt.
He was actually here at Madhouse one time.
He was here. He was here a couple months ago. He liked what was going on. It was the beginning when we first started, when I first started to come around here. And I don't live far. Yeah. But I've known Tom for a while, crossed paths many times at the shows.
Yeah.
But
we've had fun. I don't want to.
He was the driving force. No, he was the driving force for this.
Yeah.
You know, it's all good. He's given me strength.
Without a doubt.
Thanks, Pete.
And it's a good thing that you're here because I think it's good for your head, too.
And
it'll give the people the privilege of seeing these art pieces here that you've made. And I mean, we know a lot of great guitar players here, and every one of them, I mean, every single one of them can't believe the sound out of these things.
When what's-his-name was on the show when he was playing with Andre LaSalle, he actually played one of these things. And, you know, there's an old expression, you make these things talk. And I've never really heard guitar, seriously. I mean, I've seen a lot of guitars in my day, but these things actually are just absolutely amazing. From the design of it to the sound of it. So they're, who comes up with this design? Do you come up with them?
You know, when I was approached for I think we're talking about the Wavecaster, the liquid body guitars, and I was approached in 96 by ESP to come up with something special, something that had motion and movement in it. And we came up with the idea of the oil and water. So I made two for the NAMM show in January of 97. And that led to later that year being handed over to Kirk Hammett of Metallica. And he used the two for a while. And one ended up in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, one of the first ones.
How cool is that?
It has a wow factor. It's very cool.
It definitely does.
It is very cool.
Are these the only guitars that have this kind of liquid body to it?
Yeah. I haven't seen anything else out there.
Have you patented that liquid body?
No, I have not. I know now that I'm thinking about it, I believe that Fender in the custom shop made something special with water from Katrina, like it's a muddy water guitar, Mississippi water thing. I think I heard that they had made something like
that. Why haven't you patented the idea?
You know, I was never the biggest fan of design patents because I see how easily you can change something a little bit.
Yeah.
I don't know why Michelangelo never signed some of his earlier pieces, but I kind of feel like he did.
Michelangelo we know.
No, the Michelangelo, the Carver. And, you know, by themselves, they're beautiful. And, you know, I don't have to have my name sprawled across the front of it. Right. And I know who made it, you know, and that's enough for me.
And I'll tell you something. They look so cool on stage, and especially if there's a light coming through the back of them.
When they're well lit, yes, they are.
Well, you'll all get to see in a little while. I mean, it's self-explanatory, but... So this is like in 96 you started this?
Yeah, you know, I started building guitars in late 95, early 96. One of the first pieces, my buddy Lenny is here, Len Campanelli. He helped me work out some of the early issues we had with these. And we sold the first one to Alex Music on 48th Street. And then I made two more, and one of them which I have here. And I found it fascinating. I always have. I've never developed the skills to be a great player, but I found that in the building and the constructing of it, it really brings my level of creativity and excitement to build over the top.
Let me let the people out there know that George has worked with some of the biggest bands in the world. So, I mean, it's not like he's just, a guitar geek in his basement. I mean, this man has worked with the biggest bands in the world. I mean, he's, you know.
Had some great opportunities.
Yeah. Well, how many of these have you actually built?
I've built a total of 76 guitars. Six of them have been the liquid body guitars, and there are three wooden double neck guitars out there that I've constructed. But my main medium to stay in is a plexiglass. I am an acrylic artisan. I encase artifacts in an art gallery. I started with furniture and banisters, anything that you could fabricate in acrylic.
Well,
I could
let them know where, you know, I mean, because I'm sure there's going to be some people that want to get in touch with
well,
you.
Well, you know, the guitar is currently now, I have a distributor in Roslyn, New York, that would be themusiczoo.com. Okay, and they I just hooked up with them now. I've sold a total of 70 guitars, actually. I do still have six of my own pieces. But it was my intention, and Pete as well, we were going to pursue this as a business. You know, I started this again after touring for so many years. I built a shop, and I started building again. I had a lapse of probably 3 or 4 years that I didn't build at all. And you know, I wanted to start it again and bring my son into it. It was very exciting. He was a driving force in this business for me. So we're gonna continue this, you know, in his honor. And you know, I can't stop building these things.
No.
You know, it's not about money or fame or anything like that. It's really a charge to know that you made something that's so unique, but then that transfers into the hands of another artist who's a master that can
takes
play
it.
That takes it to a whole nother level that an audience appreciates. So it creates a chain of a circle of groovy goodness, you know, I don't know, to get back to the 60s. Yeah.
let's take away from the design of the guitar. What makes the sound as good as it is?
You know, I think it has something to do with the density of the acrylic. The acrylic is denser than you use some of your hardest woods, maybe by almost like 30%. And it has a tone of its own.
Yeah, it does.
It actually does. And to the amazement of so many people who look at them and sometimes maybe feel that it might be gimmicky or something, or use the P word, plastic, you know, I hate that. But once they pick them up and play them and have the sound, and I use the best components I can buy, and the best necks that I could put on. I made 7 acrylic necks, but I like the Warmoth Pro necks that are out there. He's a fella out from the West Coast. Warmoth has been making guitar products, bodies and necks for some decades now. Ken Warmoth, that's his name, yeah. The best.
But I saw, you know, because it was my show, and I could see Andre's eyes light up.
Yeah.
You could actually see his face change when he plugged that thing in and started playing it, and didn't he use it the next night at a gig or something?
We used it a few times.
Backyard. Or
Brian's Backyard Barbecue. No, we didn't get him out there. I worked with Cactus 2 weeks ago out there.
Yeah, I know.
Andre and I have been to some of the jams on the during the weeks on Long Island here. And he's played it, and many other people have. I brought him around a lot this spring and summer. We actually had a gig where I was going to bring a guitar down to Papa Chubby and Andre. That was on July 31st. And that was actually the day that Pete passed away, so we didn't get out there for that. But, you know, we'll cross paths with Andre LaSalle again.
Oh.
And he'll play a great player.
I talked to Andre a lot.
Magic Fingers, you know, one of those guys. That
so Papa Chubby never had a chance to actually
Papa
pick it
Chubby,
up?
Papa Chubby, no, he did not. He did not. But I crossed paths with him 2 weeks ago at a festival in Westport, Connecticut. And we had a nice sit down and talk, you know. Not to get off of my own guitars, but Papa Chubby has a Strat. That's real badass. It's a real, you know what? It's got his DNA is all over it.
No doubt about that. That guy is well, you were at BB King's that night when he said pull that camera right up and he dedicated that song to the guy that was dying in France.
Yeah, exactly.
And he did Somewhere Over the Rainbow. I'll tell you, everybody was just like just tears running down everybody's eyes.
He can pull some serious
that guy
out of
can.
That thing.
Flat out play, man. He can play. Yeah.
Well, what I like to do is I like to cut to commercial. When we come back, I like to show you. Let's take one guitar at a time. We'll talk about it. We'll get it on camera and we'll see what we got.
Okay.
All right. We'll be
and
right
back. And
I do
want to ask you a question when we come back.
Okay.
Stand by.
Are you planning an event and want to include entertainment, but you're not sure where to turn? Act1Entertainment.net has provided over 1,500 events with quality, affordable live entertainment at private parties, corporate affairs, festivals, bike rallies, and more. Act 1 will fit into your budget. They're friendly, reliable, and do all the legwork for you. They take all major credit cards. Log on to Act1Entertainment.net for a free, no-obligation price quote or call 631-758-3505 for a brochure.
You'll be happy you did.
Welcome to Formula Auto Wash, where every day is a great day for a car wash. Open 7 days a week from 8 a.m. to 5:30 p.m. Sundays, 8 a.m. to 4 p.m. Detailing packages for every budget, starting out at $29.99. 100% hand wash and detail center. Hogs hair and microfiber brushes and mitts. Proudly using Ecolab Blue Coral soaps and waxes. Formula Auto Wash has served the community for over 30 years. Senior discounts all day, every day. Ladies Day Wednesday, $3 off any wash. Early bird discount Monday through Thursday till 9:30 a.m. Website formulaautowash.com.
Brooklyn's best locksmith and hardware.
We have three of the largest showrooms of safes on display and in stock. You can see and touch them in person instead of browsing a catalog. We carry gun and rifle safes, burglary safes, jewelry safes, fire rated from a half hour to 2 hours. Famous name brands.
We sell Gardol.
We sell AMSAC.
The new AMSAC touchscreen.
If you're ever in need of a safe, think Brooklyn's best locksmith and hardware. Right, Lockie?
That's right, Alan.
All right, we are back.
Who do we have on the phone?
We have one of the biggest, biggest country stars in the world.
You know, I have to admit this time that I have to, and I know this is hard to come out of my mouth. It's very difficult for me to say this. But in this particular case, I got to agree with you.
Yeah, he is. He's amazing.
He's been here.
Twice.
He has played around the world.
He single-handedly made us massive in Australia. Single-handedly.
Massive.
They do radio. You can, Tom, in my life. This is Tom.
Introduce.
Are you there, Tom?
Yes, I am right here.
Tom Gent from Nashville just called in during the commercial, and it's not a setup deal. He just called in because this man is one of the most famous country singers in the world. I would say you kind of discovered Kris Kristofferson. You played with Willie Nelson. You played with everybody, haven't you?
Well, I've shared the stage with a lot of people. Of course, I have played with Kris Kristofferson, and I did play lead guitar for Mickey Newberry for a while. But, you know, and I guess I played on a few sessions.
And you played with Waylon Jennings, didn't you?
Yeah.
Well, this guy's played with everybody.
He never played with Tom Mealy.
He played with you, with your mind.
Yeah.
Well, what do you think of George's work here? Well, you haven't actually seen it yet.
I have a question for George.
Okay,
go ahead, Tom.
Which is that I've had the opportunity over the years to have spoken on a number of occasions to the late Les Paul.
Correct.
And he told me something very interesting, which is that all the guitars that he personally played with, not the ones that were, you know, manufactured, by the company, but the ones that were made for him to personally play, were all balanced electronics, because he said that the tone was much fatter and all that. How do you feel about that? I mean, what's your take on that, George?
Well, you know, there's a balance when you have the two-pickup guitar or a three-pickup. You want them to have a balance of power and of rich tone. The Wavecaster that I have here is just a one pickup guitar.
I'm basically talking about the fact that, in other words, a standard guitar uses a plug that only has two terminals on it. Mm-hmm. A jack, a quarter inch jack that has two terminals on it. Mm-hmm. Whereas the plugs that Les Paul used were basically like a TRS, where they had, you know, three. They had a ground wire also.
Mm-hmm.
And he said that he always felt that made his tone fatter, but because of the, I guess it's because the industry never got into making a guitar with what we call balanced electronics, meaning that it was grounded. They just didn't manufacture any like that. But I was just wondering if you had experimented with that, or if you if you had a take on that.
You know, it's funny, and it doesn't sound like the most intelligent answer, but you know what? If it can be clean when it's loud and have a low impedance, that's the sound I look for. People can pull lots of tones out from lots of ways. There's subtle differences that we can do with this. It's in the fingers, in the player, I guess that's my answer for you on that.
Okay. I'll buy that answer. I guess it was.
That answer is free too, by the way.
On something that he had discussed with me, and I was kind of impressed with what he had said.
Tom, have you ever seen any of these guitars that George built?
No, but I'm about to.
Well, maybe in November, George will let you play one.
Tom, we're gonna put one on camera right now. I don't know, Lenny, if you can give us a hand here in getting that guitar up. Can we get on a one single shot on camera three, Janine? This is, I don't know whether you can see that.
Oh, yeah, I can see it.
It's a liquid-filled guitar. It's filled with water and actually oil. What I'm going to try to do is I'm going to get up and try to get a little close-up on this. Janine, if we can stay on camera three for a minute.
And while we're talking, just so everybody knows, I just have to say that Tom Gent
mm-hmm.
is known, and this is a true story,
mm-hmm.
and tell me if I'm wrong, Tom, he is known for writing the saddest country western song ever written.
Really?
Is that true, Tom?
That is true.
True fact.
Tom.
I'll tell you what, he made me cry on my own couch on the set.
Maybe you've heard this before, but what happens to some of your music when you play it backwards?
Everybody smiles.
Oh, well. All right, well, we're gonna do like a little forward and a little reverse and have a happy medium.
Can you actually see this guitar?
Yes, I can see it beautifully.
Okay, what I'm going to do is I'm going to try to get our camera guy to just come out on it a little bit so you can get an idea of what it looks like. Absolutely gorgeous.
Yes, it is.
I want to. Can we show him the motion of the liquid too?
Yeah, I could see. I was seeing that happening.
Yeah.
Now, to me, it looks body style wise a bit like a. I guess it looks a little like a Strat, does it not?
No, we got a Telecaster shaped body here, Tom.
Stand it up straighter, George.
It's like with one humbucker pickup in it.
Okay.
See the liquid going down?
Yes, I do. Now you say that liquid is oil and water. Is there a certain percentage that you use best tone?
What I found with the body and aesthetics is to really split the liquid. There's approximately 33 ounces of fluid in the body.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so we probably have 16 and a half or 17 of the oil, and the same in the water. And I'm going to try and pick it up again. If we get a shot of
this one right here.
Okay.
No. Bring it into camera. Bring it into.
We got it.
That looks good. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
You see how that blue? The oil is lighter than the water.
Yeah, so I love it actually. I mean,
when it sits up like this, it almost looks like the blue is like a pickguard on an Esquire. You know,
look at that.
It's a standard H2O, quality H2O. As my good friend Happy Gilmore would say.
Hammett's guitar.
You know, the first two, Tom, that I made, I've only made six of these. The first two I made about 16 years ago, and fortunately it got into the hands of Kirk Hammett. Metallica. Uh-huh. And one of his pieces he put in the Hall of Fame in Cleveland. And if you go on their website, you look it up, you'll find one in there. It's standing up like so. And his guitar tech, probably, I don't know if he's still the same fella, a guy by the name of Justin Crew. They took the strap button out of the top horn, and they were injecting a fluorescent fluid in the guitars at night when Kurt would use it for a few songs. And it would create a stunning effect when lit. The material, whatever they were using, the fluid, it ended up dissipating within the body. But what they didn't realize at the time is that when they drilled through the sidewall of the body, when they put a self-tapping screw back in, some of the oil and water eventually leaked out. So the one that's in the Hall of Fame is without fluid.
It's on wow. E.
It's on E. Very, very good. But I know he has a second one. And what I've done on the new ones here now, I wrap a machine screw with a Teflon tape, like a plumber's tape, and it prevents anything from leaking out. The tone, it's funny how the tone, you have a richer tone with this, with the oil in the body. You don't hear a sloshing around in the body, but it has a warm sound for acrylic. It's not like mahogany, but it has a tone of its own.
Yeah, it does.
I'll say it.
Tom, we're going to be we're fortunate enough to have somebody here that's going to be playing this. If you want to stick with us, obviously I know that coming through television, it's not going to be as if you were live here in the studio, but I'm sure it's going to do it some justice. It really does sound incredible.
Oh, Lenny, the pressure's on now.
Yeah, Tom, we got someone that's going to do this some justice. Yeah.
Make some noise with it. But Tom, we can't thank you enough for calling in, and please, please keep me in your loop. I'd like to come in and see you.
I definitely will, and I will. I'm going to get off the line because we've got a big delay between us, and it's kind of weird, you know.
Yeah.
I'll be talking, and you'll be talking, and I'm going, wait a minute, nobody's listening.
You'll have to catch up to yourself.
There you go.
Okay. Hey, God bless you guys.
Love you, Tom, and thank you for calling, and definitely stay in touch, and I'd love you to do the show again, too.
I'm going to.
Okay.
I'm going to, brother.
Beautiful.
All right.
Thanks.
Say hello to everybody.
Nice talking to you, Mr. George.
Thank you, Tom. I hope to meet you someday.
Take care.
You got to play one of these, Tom.
I'm going to try it.
All right.
Cool. All right. Take care.
Bye-bye.
Bye. Great guy.
Okay, listen, why don't we cut the commercial, and when we come back, let's hear Lenny doing his thing.
Let's do it.
You want to do it?
Sounds like a plan.
I think the people are all eager right. And waiting.
We're going to cut to a quick commercial.
It's easy for you to say.
I get excited, when I'm... But we're going to cut to a quick commercial.
Isn't this a great show?
I don't have a beer yet. Jesus Christ. We'll be right back after this, okay? How's that sound?
Have a beer.
There you go.
Are you planning an event and want to include entertainment, but you're not sure where to turn? Act1Entertainment.net has provided over 1,500 events with quality, affordable live entertainment at private parties, corporate affairs, festivals, bike rallies, and more. Act One will fit into your budget. They're friendly, reliable, and do all the legwork for you. They take all major credit cards. Log on to Act1Entertainment.net for a free, no-obligation price quote or call 631-758-3505 for a brochure. You'll be happy you did.
So then I said, Mr. Prime Minister, I'm flattered that you love chocolate, but I'm here strictly in a professional. What's wrong with him?
He thinks you're naked.
My shell is brown. It just looks like my milk chocolate is showing. Only a fool would think I'd actually show up naked.
So it's that kind of party. Hit it!
I'm sexy and I know it.
Eva, one of our 4 million owners, has her cat insured with Folksam. This one is for you.
I believe I can fly. I believe I can touch the sky. I think about it every night and day. Spread my wings and fly away. I believe I can soar. I see me running.
Visit folksam.se and tell us what makes your heart beat faster.
For professional motorcycle transport and towing, think Kickstart Fabrications Motorcycle Towing. Proudly serving all of Long Island, we feature expert handling and 24/7 service. So send a limo for your toy with Kickstart Fabrications Motorcycle Towing.
All right, we are back with Crossfire right here in the Madhouse Studios, and we got a special guest, George Fedden here, who has created some of the most amazing guitars you'll ever see in your entire life. You know, I really think it's going to be self-explanatory from this point on. And we have Len Campanelli here to demonstrate some of George's work, and you'll get a better look at the guitar. And maybe we could start off with, maybe George or Lenny, one of you explain why we have the Hendrix look over there.
Good evening. I'm enjoying the show. Hope you are as well. Come out with my old friend George to talk a little bit about the guitars. George and I have been friends for a long, long time. And when we were thinking of doing one together, you know, where I had some input on George's design, I always wanted a guitar that kind of simulated the way Hendrix took a left-handed guitar and turned it, took a right-handed guitar and turned it upside down, and then you had the upside down Fender headstock. And when you did that, you also got the backwards effect, because a normal Stratocaster has the pickups slanted in this fashion. But when he turned it over, he automatically turned it around backwards, picking up a little bit more treble on the bass side and giving away a little bit on the treble side. Not only that, the entire feel of the fingerboard changed, because now the low E string was the longest, changing its tension, and the high E was the shortest, changing its tension. So a few things changed harmonically, tonally, and in feel on the actual fingerboard. George was very, very cool in reproducing these wants on this guitar for me, and he built a beauty. I'm not sure if anybody's aware of this. This is basically a Stratocaster, exact Stratocaster guitar, three pickups, two tones, volume, and pickup selector.
Just let it be known that that one, it doesn't have liquid in it, right?
No, this is solid.
Yeah, because I'm sure acrylic. They're looking for the liquid.
Solid acrylic. And it's kind of hefty. It's a little thinner in the body than a regular Strat, but
only by 1/8 of an inch.
1/8 of an inch. But it's pretty gutsy. It's got a beautiful wooden neck with highly figured bird's eye maple on it. George and I were talking before he got to work on this. In the 1954, was it? 54
Seven.
Catalog?
57.
Oh, 57 catalog. Fender actually made a bunch of acrylic guitars with acrylic necks. They made six of them to demonstrate how the truss rods worked and the electronics worked for their dealers. And boy, would I like to get my hands on one of those just for collectability. They're probably worth a ton. And they had trims, whereas this one is a hardtail. Strings go straight through the body, and it gives it a little bit more of a punchy tone because you have a lot of continuity between the fulcrums. It's a great playing guitar, great looking guitar, although I must say somebody like Barbie Benton would look good.
Someone naked.
In a bikini.
Barbie Benton, 1968.
But George does magnificent work. I mean, that is not a word to be used lightly. George does magnificent work. He started out, I believe, years ago doing acrylic, custom acrylic furniture and banisters and all kinds of really, really eclectic stuff and incredible, incredibly accurate work. So when he did this, he applied all that and his love of guitar to the instrument. You know, very much the way Leo Fender started out building radios and fixing phonographs and then got into building guitars and made, only the most popular electric guitars in the world. George started out building furniture and made these. We had a little bit at soundcheck. We had a little bit of a ground loop problem, so I'm not playing through an amp. I hope you can hear the actual clarity of the instruments played through the amp. We're in studio, so we're not using a whole heck of a lot of volume, but they are very clear in tone reproduction. That I really enjoy playing them, and they ring true, they play nicely, they feel great. Balance is not a problem, although it's sitting on my lap with a guitar strap. It's quite a piece to sit on you. It feels more like a Les Paul than a Stratocaster, but you need the bulk for the kind of tones that it reproduces. These produce sounds, classic sounds coming from high impedance pickups that all Stratocasters, Les Pauls, and guitars of the ilk play utilizing. The gentleman on the phone, Tommy, was asking about balance pickups. He was asking about low impedance pickups. Those pickups worked great for Les Paul because Les was a jazz player who really wanted a nice, clean, bell-like tone, whereas us guitar players from this a day mostly want a little bit of bite, a little bit more guts, a little bit of grit, and sustain. So the high impedance pickups seem to work better. They break up better. They distort better. And when you need to, you can roll them back, and they still sound pretty darn good. Don't you think, George?
It sounds good. I love them all. I love them all. Len. What about the Wavecaster? You want to do it? You want to play something on that?
Yeah, there it is. Camera number two.
Lenny, let's try the Wavecaster. We'll unplug the Strat and just give that one.
It didn't do that before. Sorry about that.
Shut the blue down.
Keeps our viewers awake.
We may have blown the board.
Oh, no.
Yeah, that's what happens. Let's try it. No, so far so good. Okay, we're good. All right, let's take the blues down all the way on two. OK?
Go ahead, Lenny.
I love them. They play well. They look good. They're extremely unique. And George has just sealed a deal with a quality retailer here on the island, a place called The Music Zoo, who are selling these guitars for George. And you can buy one of these. You can custom order. Lots of different things. But The Music Zoo in Roslyn is selling the guitars and marketing them for George. A fellow by the name of Tommy Coletti, a really old friend of mine from Long Island, is another the proprietor of the Music Zoo. And it's quite an establishment. He's got the greatest of any make, model, or type of guitar. But Tommy has got the good and solid insight to and foresight.
Very impressed with his
place. He was very impressed with the guitars to take these on and start selling them. So give him a call at the Music Zoo. Look them up, themusiczoo.com. Take it away, boys.
All right. Well, hey, listen. You know, it's they're amazing. I mean, I wish really people could actually hear it the way we're hearing it in here, and you know. I guess they're just going to have to take our word for it that they sound as good as they look. Mm-hmm. And I hope when Tom comes down, you never know, you know.
Oh, he'll definitely.
I mean, he's definitely got to play one of these guitars. And
you got to go.
Anything else that you want to say about these guitars? I mean, we've got only a couple of minutes left here.
Well, let's just say this. I'm not going to stop building them, you know.
Did he say you're going to build them?
My abilities with these go further than what we're looking at right now. There's going to be multiple colors. I have lots of other ideas for this.
Different types of necks.
Different types.
Is there any way of us getting a three-camera shot up here?
We got.
There you go.
We still have plans for some others coming up.
Well, let me ask you too, George. Isn't it absolutely wonderful to be doing what you really love to do?
You want to know?
Isn't that the best part?
And some people have said this to me. You know, I haven't had a preset or an agenda in life. I love to do what I love to do. You know, live the life I love and love the life I live. You know, music and art is my blood flow. The abilities that God has given me to create what I do, it's overwhelming to me. I love it.
Let's face it, you're a rare guy.
It's the top of the top.
Not many people, even though they have great jobs and they're well-paying jobs, they don't really love what they do.
Yeah, I don't really work for a living. You know, I pay bills like everyone else.
Like that.
But
well, hopefully,
you love what you do. You'll never work a day in your life.
It's still exciting to wake up in the morning.
No, you told me we're getting a Winnebago.
That's what we're getting.
Could you imagine Madhouse TV on the road going throughout the country?
Wouldn't that be great?
That would be wild. Sounds like the plan. We got to get a reality show.
And another quick
question.
Have you ever done a bass guitar?
Yes, I have, actually. I made two bass guitars. They were the jazz bass. Big, heavy body with a transparent blue pickguard. I like blue is my favorite color. It was my dad's, too.
Mine, too.
I think it was only the one bass. It was three double neck guitars in wood, one acrylic bass, and the rest acrylic guitars. You know, I can make any kind of shape.
I'd like to see some purple liquid in one of these.
Well, it's funny that you mention that, because the next one that I'm making is going to have a red food dye in the water and a blue lamp oil. So that when you turn it on its back and you look through the two colors, you'll see purple.
Cool.
Red and blue makes
love purple.
That's
why. And it's great on stage. Purple is great.
Oh, George, thanks so much for being here on Madhouse TV.
Thanks for having us, guys. Lenny and I both appreciate this.
Lenny, it's been a pleasure having you down here. Okay, guys, listen, it's that time of the night again. And tune in next week. Next week we have a very unusual show. Right now we're going to be, it looks like that it's in the works. And, of course, follow us on Facebook throughout the week. But it appears that we're going to be Skyping in from Switzerland. We're going to have somebody, a singer-songwriter, actually Skyping in live here from Switzerland. And it's going to be our first international show. As you know, Madhouse TV is becoming very popular over in Europe, in Argentina, down in South America, and Australia. Now Australia. And now we have people over in Switzerland, and we're going to have the pleasure of having this gentleman Skype in. Watch Facebook. Stay tuned to Facebook, please, as to all the details coming up.
Well, and I want to say to George, I sincerely thank you for coming in, I feel like really good about getting this out to the world, because I mean, anywhere if there's a guy in a cave in Africa, he can watch it if he's on a computer. So you never know with these. So listen,
painted a picture in my mind. I see him now.
Yeah, I see him calling Roswell.
Yeah, he's calling.
But Roswell. Anyway, guys, we got to run. You've been watching Crossfire. I'm Tom Mealy.
I am Tommy Ma.
And we'll be back here next week, same time.
Stay tuned. And also, Lenny, you sounded great over there, bro.
Be safe out there, people, until we see you next week. Peace.
Thanks.